Sticking in the US, Time magazine went to Kamala Harris and asked her for an interview for an upcoming profile, and Kamala Harris said no, which she said to basically anyone who's asked her for an interview. And I've been a journalist for most of my working life, and generally the rule has been that if you ask someone for an interview and they say no, you blackball them because they have something to hide. If you don't want to play the game with me, then why would I do anything to support you? But Time magazine, nevertheless, has come out with a gushing front page. Take a look at this. This is what they are putting out about Kamala, even though she won't even cooperate with them. It's being described, and you can see, look at that image there. Oh, she looks like Barack Obama. She's about to sweep in and take over the US. I think the headline on the front of the magazine says, "It's her time." I mean, for heaven's sake, you could not be more gushing, could you? And it's worth noting as well the comparison between Trump and Harris when they have put both of them on the front page. Take a look at this side-by-side image. I mean, you can see there what they are getting at,
spot
right?
Spot the difference. Compare the pair.
And this has been roundly criticised, as you can imagine. David Hogg, who's a gun control activist in the US, says, you know, elections come down to vibes and Kamala has got the vibes right now. And this is the point. This is what they are driving towards. We talked before about humanising Donald Trump. What they are trying to do here is humanise Kamala Harris in a certain way and laud her, because anyone who's actually watched her recognises that she's a bit loco. But, you know, if we build her up enough, if we build her up, surely she'll be able to get over the line. Others have carried on. Joey Manarino on Twitter said, he is the new cover of Time magazine. They worship a woman, as I said before, who refuses to even talk to them. Absolutely ridiculous and absurd. And this is the thing, like, I cannot think of any other politician, candidate, etc., who could so roundly ignore the media and yet still get the complete support of the media. Generally, if you go for an interview with someone and they refuse, like, it's full court press against them. You've given them the opportunity to have their say. They've refused to have their say. Well, we're coming for you now. But instead, for Kamala, it's a protection racket.
I remember many years ago, someone gave me a 12-month subscription to Time magazine, and I was so excited. These days, you could not pay me to read Time magazine, although because we were talking about it tonight, I guess I was paid to read it, and I did. So you don't have to. A 3,000-word essay, which could basically be summarised as vibe, TikTok and vibe. They described Kamala Harris as a cross between Beyoncé and Obama.
Oh,
what?
And they said, and I quote, "She's pulled off the swiftest vibe shift in modern political history, because politics is all about vibe shifts."
Oh,
they said,
God,
she's dominated TikTok and she's campaigning in a fight for the future, without describing what that meant. But they did say also she was a, quote, Jedi master who's been underestimated. But when people underestimated her, they didn't count on, get this, Liz, her ability to create viral memes and to eye roll at Republican weirdos.
Oh. Wow.
They said she's been endorsed by celebrities such as Charlie XCX.
Oh. Who's that?
And Megan the Stallion.
Oh.
I had to ask my 19-year-old boys, who are these people? They also said a union leader has called her, quote, a badass woman, which
Woo.
Is a raging endorsement.
I didn't know John Secker had endorsed Kamala Harris.
Let me give you a few more highlights. They said elections come down to vibes, and Kamala has got the vibes right now. And the Time magazine, 3,000 words, it finished with a 39-year-old woman interviewed to make the final comment. This is where they land, right?
Oh,
and they interview
okay,
this woman because they found her. She was wearing a Childless Cat Ladies for Harris T-shirt, which qualifies her to speak. And she said, quote, "The whole vibe has just shifted."
Political
I'm so
analyst,
glad I read it.
I think political analyst Rob Smith put it well when he said, in 3 weeks, the US regime propaganda media transformed Kamala Harris from a national embarrassment to an iconic and transformational politician, while not even pretending to know or care what she believes.
Accurate.
Absolutely incredible. Here's the White House press secretary asked by a reporter to just name some of Kamala Harris's achievements. Do you think the press secretary could do it?
What does the president see as the vice president's biggest achievement during their time in office together?
So look, because they've been partners, those achievements have been done, certainly those historic, unprecedented achievements have been done together. I'll say this, the president believes in the vice president leadership, her temperament, her experience, and he has said this himself. One of the proudest decisions that he made in 2020 was selecting her as vice president because he believed that she can go on day one. And you've seen that, you've seen them do that together on day one of this administration. That doesn't change. I'm not going to parse out anything from here.
Of course, she couldn't name any, could she? Because there are none. Kamala Harris has been touted as the most useless VP in the world, in the history of American politics. She's wildly unpopular, but it just goes to show, once the media machine kicks in, everyone just gets on board. That's what they do best, and haven't they done a number on a lot of people in America?